This video is brought to you by Videoblocks. Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday. A while ago, we created a similar video showing three Hollywood effects from Wonder Woman, Superman, and Star Wars. Today, we're taking a look at three new effects and we're kicking it off with Mission Impossible. There's not really a specific scene that we're going to recreate, but look at any of those films and there's probably a shot in there where someone jumps from one roof to another. Now we had different ideas to pull this effect off, so we first tested it on a small scale in the studio. It went great, so let's take it now to a larger scale.
It has been raining a lot yesterday, so the first thing that I'm gonna do is check the roof for water and clean it up if necessary.
The battery is dead.
Take two. Hey!
We filmed this on a drone, but of course you can also do this on a tripod if you have the ability to set it up somewhere. The green screen will be the gap later on, so make sure it lays straight. And by the way guys, we have created a collection of green screen gear that we use, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. Now on the viewfinder of the drone, we then mark the perspective of the roof, and in the meanwhile, I could jump over that green screen. And this is your first shot, then fly backwards and film the side of the building. Now make sure that it fits within that same perspective that you've drawn on the display. Snap your shot and head over to Premiere Pro.
Hey, Janik!
Cut the hair, Jordy!
Hashtag keep the hair.
Place your jumping shot on track number 2. Then head over to the effects library and choose the ultra key, which you can apply to this clip. This effect allows you to key out to green. We've actually done an in-depth green keying tutorial a while back. If this is all new to you, then I'll leave a link to that video in the description below as well. After the keying is done, place your second clip on track number 1. It will reveal itself underneath that keying. First, right-click and choose Add Frame Hold. Reposition the facade of the building so that it matches with the gap. Now, if your perspective wasn't looking so good, you can always apply the basic 3D effect to it and stretch the clip to have it match better. And finally, you probably want to stabilize your jump shot. This can easily be done using the Warp Stabilizer. Add it to the top clip and change the result to No Motion. Next up, we're going to recreate the famous E.T. scene where you can see the bike flying through the air. For this one, you want to set up a complete green screen that fits the entire subject. As we'll be working with a moon in the background, we're also going to set up a backlight to make it match better. The moon that I got is a stock clip from Videoblocks, which is an online library where you can find all kinds of stock clips, video effects, After Effects templates, and much more. And the great thing is that you only have to pay a single price per year, which gives you unlimited downloads. Now, if you'd like to check it out too, then make sure to click the first link in the description below. Janik was holding my steer so that I could keep my balance while I was riding the bike. So the stock clip goes on your first track in my timeline. On top of that goes the green screen shot. With that clip selected, head over to the effects controls, from which you want to click on the pen tool under the opacity property. This allows you to draw a mask around your subject to get rid of the surrounding, making the keying go easier. Important is that you cut off the arms of your pal who was holding the bike. Then with the ultra key effect, you can again remove the green like we did before. And this already blends your shot with the background. Now simply scale and position your clip to where you want it to start. Create a keyframe for the position and move forward in time. Drag your clip to the right. The animation will now go in a straight line. And with the motion property selected, we can see the animation path and the program monitor. From here, you also can see these levers, and if you pull on them, you can change the animation path into a curve, which gives you a better flying bike. And since we're going in a curve now, we're also going to animate the rotation a tiny bit. For the final touch, I'm opening up Lumetri as we want to blend the clip better with the background. We are shooting against a bright moon, so decrease the exposure a bunch and increase the contrast to create a silhouette of yourself. As you will see, my tires were flat, so this flying trick came in pretty handy. That brings us to the last Hollywood effect. Did you ever want to be Spider-Man? Well, it's actually super easy. We're going to start with a shot of a building. Have your camera sit on a tripod as we're going to blend ourselves into the facade. To make it yourself easy, film from a low angle. Next, we're laying down a green screen in the studio. It's very important here to tighten the green screen well. Tape it to the ground or something. Then match the perspective of your first shot a little bit when setting up the camera. And since we got a low angle shot, we don't have to go too high with the camera in the studio. And of course, also match the lighting. If it's a cloudy day, you want to use a softbox. If there was a hard sunlight, you can use hard lighting in the studio as well. Take the shot of you crawling for a little distance, and then in Premiere Pro, we're going to mask again around the subjects. After that, we can apply the Ultra key to remove the green. And now simply rotate, scale, and position yourself so that it seems like you're climbing up to the building. And once your clip sits in place, the effect should already work. And if you need some more shadow to sell the effect better, you can always use the drop shadow effect. Adjust its settings to make sure it seems natural. Now, since everything was shot from a tripod, the result could look pretty static. And that's why I'm adding a fake handheld camera motion to an adjustment layer that we've laid on top. These are a bunch of presets which you can download for free from our website. Again, link in the description.
Lorenzo! Get off the wall! Get back to work, Lorenzo!
And that was it again! Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you, Videoblogs, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Janik, stop playing with drones!
Jordy, your hair is getting too wild! Catch this!
Ah! Stop! Yeah. Janik!